Are you smart enough to study physics? It's a fair enough question, and sometimes people ask me this question to get my opinion on their situation. They might say something like, oh, I've got good grades in these math and physics courses that I've taken at school so far. Do you think I'll be able to handle doing, say, an undergraduate degree in physics? You know, am I smart enough to do that? And the answer to that is probably yes. Like, if you've already done well in whatever math and science or physics courses you've taken so far, you probably do have what it takes to, you know, just keep going in that field and to do some tertiary studies in physics. But I think the real question here, what you should be thinking about, is not deciding that you are smart enough to do physics, but instead deciding that you're going to be smart enough. So physics is definitely not easy for anyone, no matter how smart they think they are. And it's going to take a lot of self-motivation, self-discipline, and it's going to take you deciding, you know, that you're willing to put in the work and everything it takes to excel at physics. You're also going to need to do away with any sort of romantic ideas you might have about what it's like to be a physicist. And people sometimes get these ideas through physics and the way it's portrayed in like documentaries or on TV. Often physics is portrayed in a way that makes it feel very romantic, that it's sort of like this fantasy where you don't need to understand all of the mathematical, you know, underpinnings of an idea to be able to make advances, and then it's just a matter of thinking up all these pseudo-religious sort of thoughts about physics and what you believe is true about the universe. The way that physics is portrayed like that, I don't think is a very good representation of what it's really like to work as a physicist or to be in academia at all. Also, the way that physics is portrayed in the media makes you feel like you need to be a genius to get very far in it, that you need to have this sort of crazy scientist or Einstein or Sheldon Cooper type qualities about you to be a physicist. But I think that's also not a very good representation of what it's really like. The idea of IQ being like a measure of whether you're smart enough to study physics, I think, is not very good. I think taking this raw intelligence quotient is not very useful to telling you, you know, if you have the skills that it takes to be good at physics. There's definitely very smart people who excel in other fields who aren't good at physics, and likewise people who are really good at physics are not necessarily so good at some other fields. So I think instead of getting caught up on if your IQ is high enough and you have this sort of raw intelligence measure, you should be thinking, is this field a good fit for my intelligence? So I definitely think people have different strengths. Some people won't be good at physics because it just doesn't fit with the strengths that they have. So I'm going to now show you a few practical things you can do, basically Google searches you can do and things you can look at to find out if physics is something that suits well with your strengths. So all I've done so far is to go to Google and to type in the phrase MIT physics syllabus. Now I've chosen MIT as my example uni here, but you could replace that with literally any uni that you're interested in, maybe one you're planning to go to. Essentially, we're just seeking out a physics syllabus from an undergraduate physics course. MIT is a good example because a lot of their stuff is like open courseware and their website's pretty good. So that search has led me to the MIT Department of Physics website. Now, most university physics departments will have their own website with something similar to this on it. This is information for prospective physics majors. It talks a little bit about what you'd be learning, and it then talks about the exact courses that you would be taking, and it gives some of their course codes as well. The information we're getting out of this is the core subjects involved and what their course codes are called. From this page, I was able to click on information about undergraduate courses, and I get to a page like this one here. Now, this is also somewhat common for any university's page. It's a list of the courses that you can take. This is all the physics subjects. I could sort this by graduate or by undergraduate. These are all the courses that you could be taking, and then it has information about each of them, including the textbooks that are involved. So, if we go down this list, if we just want to click on something like classical mechanics, we'll be taken to here, and we get told some of the actual ideas that are involved in all of these courses. There's also a little link here to textbooks, and it says here for this classical mechanics course, the textbook is Landau and Lipschitz, and that's the required one. And I mean, you can go and seek this textbook out yourself and have a read of it, and actually know what you'd be learning in this course. And maybe you can try some of the practice examples from the textbook, and they're likely going to be very similar to whatever the exam questions or the assignment questions are if you were taking this course. It says here that you could, buy this textbook yourself. I would recommend that as maybe a last resort, probably if you're at a uni, you have access to a uni library. You don't need to be a student to go to a uni library. Anyone can just go in and read the textbooks there without checking them out. I would probably try to do that, try to just, get a little bit of a read of this before you invest the money into buying it. There are some less than legal ways to get them online, but I'm not going to talk about that too much. But essentially, I think this could be very useful for you if you really want to know what's involved in the physics course before you actually sign up. So, yeah, here's a list of all those courses, and there's a list of all the textbooks. This is also a great way to teach yourself physics. If you can't afford to go to uni or it's just not possible for you, you can learn a lot of the same things just by looking at what these MIT classes are actually going to be doing. So, like I said, you can do that for pretty much any uni that has a good and functional website and puts that sort of stuff online. Then I did the same thing for Cambridge, because that's another famous uni. Many people would be interested in knowing what they do at Cambridge. And so I just Googled something like Cambridge Department of Mathematics and Physics. And once I was on that department page, it was pretty easy to just click around to find some course information. So this page is about the undergraduate mathematics course, the Mathematical Tripos, last 3 or 4 years. And then it's talking a little bit about what's involved, and there was a link to courses. After following that link for a little bit, I ended up with this document here, and this is all about each of the courses that's involved in this Mathematical Tripos. Okay, so there's a lot of intro stuff about, what's going on in the course. But then we get into the juice a little bit down here, and they go through each of the courses. So maybe even it's just each of the subject areas, and it's like numbers and sets, differential equations, probability, and they go through and they're saying these are the specific learning outcomes. These are what you're going to learn in the course. And again, they have some appropriate textbooks. So again, I would say if you really want to know if you're good enough to do this stuff, check out some of those textbooks, try a few of the problems after reading, a bit of the sections, and if that's doable for you, then you're probably more than good enough to actually enroll in the course for real. In fact, this might give you a good head start. I'm going to put all of these links in the description so you can check out these exact documents, or you can try to find your own just with a bit of Googling. Another thing you can do is, if you get course codes, which I was showing you on one of the previous pages, they're like the 8.03 or whatever it is, like the number that represents the course. You can then Google that course code and maybe type it in and type like assignments or exams or something, and you might be able to find a bit more about that course from like maybe it has its own separate web page. That's something I'd probably try as well if you're really curious to see what people are learning in that course. Not everything is going to be open to you, but some unis definitely put more stuff online than others. MIT, I said, is a good example of having a lot of open courseware that you can just have a look at. It's the same thing with exams often. Just from this University of Cambridge page, you can go to past exam papers, and then there's a bunch of PDF documents here. I'll just click on a random one, and then you can take a look at this exam here. Sometimes this is what I just do in my videos. I just Google, physics exam on some particular topic, and I just show you guys what is like some one of the first Google results. Sometimes you send me messages like, oh, thank you so much for showing me what an astrophysics exam is like. I've always wanted to know. But I mean, you could just Google it yourself. I enjoy showing you guys and giving my commentary, but there's a lot of stuff that you can just, you know, do a bit of research into on your own. I guess because I've been through the whole uni system, I'm aware of what's out there. But I know that, you know, if you are at high school or you just haven't been through this uni system, you might not know that this sort of stuff actually exists online. Hopefully that does help you make a decision about whether physics is something that's suited to your intelligence and to your strengths. But, you know, if you're spending so much time worrying about if you're smart enough to study physics, it's probably not the right mindset to have. And maybe if you are so concerned, maybe it isn't the right thing for you, because I know from my experience, I sort of just dove into it with that decision that it was just going to work. I was just going to have to be smart enough, and I didn't try to worry about anything really too much, except just focusing on my courses and learning the stuff that was involved. Best wishes from me for anything that you do decide to follow, and thanks for watching.